Well, I'm English, as you could tell by the accent, and I studied at the University of Birmingham, and I stayed on there till about 1982, and then I went to University of Alberta in Canada originally for a 2-year visit, but the mountains were too attractive, and Margaret Thatcher was too much of a disincentive to stay in the UK, so I went there permanently. And my career basically has been about understanding organisational change. In particular, I got interested in professional service firms like accounting, law, consulting firms, investment banks, and in particular from an institutional theory perspective. So that's what I've been fiddling about with for the last 25 years. Like I say, Margaret Thatcher was doing nasty things to the university system. And Alberta gave me lots of the kinds of resources you need, not money resources necessarily, all the resources you need to do a proper research exercise. So that was very inducive. I think, well, what the U of A did, you could probably boil it down. There's a lot of luck involved, but I think there are three things I would emphasize. One is it recognized you have to have a research culture. So, how do we get a research culture? You get a research culture by organizing visiting speaker series, get doctoral students to present their work, you go out for grants, which involve more than one person doing the research, etc. Two, you have to give time. And the U of A has been very generous in terms of teaching buyouts and things like that, because you can't do research if you're obsessed with teaching. And teaching is very important, don't get me wrong. But when you've got teaching and research, teaching's routinized, it's bureaucratized. There's times when you have to be in a classroom, times when you have to do exams. Research can't be fitted around it, especially qualitative research, which requires you in the field. So they gave very generous buyouts to productive researchers, and that once you get that going, it works well. Third thing they did was they recognized research in their promotion tenure decisions. So if you don't have that kind of personal motivation, you're not going to do it. But when the organization reinforces that, that's good. Third thing, hire people. And so we hired deliberately certain kinds of people, and we were quite good at nurturing them, and if they weren't making the grade, we would let them go. Well, I think there's at least one thing which is clear right now, that the American ethnocentricity is being broken down. The Academy of Management is much more international than it ever was. The Board of Governors of the Academy is recognizing the importance of seeing itself as international. Same thing happening in Europe. EGOS, which is very proud to be a European institution, for the first time next year will host its major conference in Montreal. Now, admittedly, that's French Canadian, but it's still not Helsinki, London, Paris. It's overseas. And I think that international dimension is very important, and I think very exciting. The other thing, which is a challenge for institutionalists, is there's a stronger recognition now in the academy that's got to be relevant. It wants to speak to big issues in society, and it's about time we did. Because although we have economists in the academy, they tend to be elsewhere. Economists are listened to, sometimes they shouldn't be. We're not listened to, and we should be. And I think that's probably going to come.